it looked like he wants to learn each and everything, and he wants to enjoy each and every moment of the JTC club. He is working in a modern aluminium in the maintenance department. Please help me welcome Toastmaster Nagaraj to the podium, please. The title of his speech is Ego versus Attitude. Ego versus Attitude, Toastmaster Nagaraj. Time allotted is 5 to 7 minutes.
Attitude. Your attitude makes a huge difference that how successful you will be in your life. Fellow Toastmasters, distinguished guests, good evening.
Good evening.
Those who are in attitude often misunderstood as arrogant and bad persons. Why? So how we should be behaving? What is the way? Well, before going to exact definition of attitude, let's remember two things. Number one is, this topic is very complex. It is complex, but today I'm going to give you simple examples and simple solution to be applied in your life practically. And number two is, attitude is very huge. And ego is a small part of it. For example, if attitude is a continent, ego is one continent. But often people get confused between ego and attitude because we can divide attitude in two parts. One is right attitude and other one is wrong attitude. And ego is a part of wrong attitude. But the good thing is, you can be a person with right attitude without keeping an ego. So, now coming back to the definition of attitude. Attitude, it says how we respond or behave to any situation or to any person. But ego says about self, self-importance, being selfish, that ego says. But as I said, you can be a person with right attitude. For example, every Indian is Asian, right?
Yes.
Right. Can every Asian be Indian?
No.
Not possible, right? Similarly, a person with attitude will have, we may not have ego, but the person with ego will have attitude. You have to be able to differentiate between them. So, as I said, this is very complex topic. People misunderstand each other. Okay, you know what is actually the problem with our generation? As soon as we achieve small success, we start to lose our humbleness. Start to become arrogant. But we do not realize that is the point where we start to lose what we already have. Be it in self-respect, be it in humbleness, be it the people around us. When I'm saying people around us, it doesn't mean your family or your friends. No. It means every individual you come across every single day. It starts from your house, your office, security guard in your office, a tea boy, a janitor, your colleagues, and even your boss. The way you treat them. A right attitude person will treat everyone with equal respect. Equal respect to everyone. But mostly we may miss it. We may do it in other way. We may judge people according to their titles, their positions. But we should try to avoid this. Okay, let me ask, why we often fight with our own brothers and sisters? Those who are born with same mother, right? We share same blood, but still we fight. What is the reason? It is an ego. ego, but nothing else. So, what actually the other person is? Understanding, right? We complain others that she is not understanding me, and if you ask her, she will say the same thing. He is not understanding me. What both of us need? Understanding. When the requirement is same, when the requirement is same from both sides, she needs understanding, I need understanding. So why we don't come to a common conclusion and solve it once and all? What is stopping us? Can anyone guess what is stopping us?
Ego.
Ego, right? Will not allow you. Will not allow you to sort out this thing. What if I tell you, simple solution for this one, as I said before. But if I tell, okay, my dear, I'm sorry, I understand you, let's fix it. Isn't it very simple? But your attitude will make a barricade in between you and your loved ones, and it will not allow you to cross that barricade. It will not allow you to cross that barricade. So, how to destroy this ego? I will tell you one thing. As soon as you are in this situation, say to yourself that you are learning. You are learning to say sorry for your mistake. You are learning to say sorry for her mistake also, because you don't want to repeat the mistake she did or he did. Right? As soon as you say this, you are learning. Your brain will create an image of a learner. Learners make mistakes, right? They don't tell you. Your ego cannot cross this thought. So that is the point where your ego will not come in between. Right? So, today I want to leave all of you with three thoughts. Be an humble person. Treat everyone with equal respect. And be an attitude of learner. Because learners never blame others. Thank you very much.